the three exercises through which you can practice English speaking alone at home. So guys, do you want to practice English speaking but you don't have any partner? So what do you do in this particular situation? Hello everyone, my name is Shaliman. Welcome back to my another lesson of learning English with me. So well, today I am going to tell you something through which you can practice your English speaking skills so that you can become fluent to improve your speaking skills. Here you need to practice, but how to practice without a partner? That's a big question. So today I have three techniques, guys. I have three techniques for you to through which you can practice your English speaking alone at home without any partner. So are you all ready for this? So before beginning, please subscribe to this channel and so that you can get all the lessons that I have posted for you on this channel. And please like the video and share it with your friends too. So now coming back to today's lesson, how to practice English alone at home. For that, I have, you know, three techniques. You can say three exercises which are going to help you to improve your speaking skills. And you can practice speaking and improve your speaking skills, because this is important for you to speak out. Speaking practice will promote your fluency. These three techniques are superb. So let's begin with them. So that exercise number one is to speak on 15 different topics, 15 days. So for 15 days, you have to take 15 different topics to do your English speaking practice and speak on these topics. How when you have a topic, you have a direction, you have a theme on which you are supposed to speak. It's easier for you to speak on that particular topic. Either you can take up the selfie talk technique to speak on that topic, or you can, you know, just do English speaking practice using these topics. Select a topic, okay, take it up, and you can prepare on the particular topic for a minute, okay? So guys, if you want, you can take your time and take a minute for two, or you can even create some kind of notes, okay? But you are not supposed to take up those notes and read them, okay? So these are for you to jot down your thoughts, okay? So that you have your thoughts, whatever you want to say, your content, sort it out. In order to sort out that content, you can take the help of a notepad, okay, and a pen, and then note down something, that some ideas related to your particular topic, okay? And you are taking up a topic, for example, taking up the topic of the last vacation you had, okay? You are taking up that particular topic now. When you are taking up the topic, like, you don't have to write paragraph after paragraphs. No, just write down few ideas in front of the word. Okay, a little phrases, a note, example. You can just write down the name of the place and the feelings associated with it. That's it. Short note, that's it. You have to just jot down your thoughts so that you are prepared to speak. Okay, well, prepared to speak for a long amount of time. Now there is a one more rule to this particular exercise, that you have to speak for at least 1 minute continuously. Okay, try to speak between 1 to 3 minutes. That is what you are supposed to do. So start with 1 minute in the beginning. Okay, you are at the one day or 2 days, you have to speak for 1 minute, 2 minutes, okay? You can do is, as you are reaching day 15, that means you are progressing with this particular technique, with the particular exercise, okay? You need to increase your speaking capacity, okay? You need to increase your speaking. There should, the longer you are able to speak, that is your capacity, okay? That you are able to speak for a long amount of time. And we have to increase that too. Just speaking practice, guys, it's not enough. Speaking fluently means that you are able to speak in English for a long amount of time, okay? This capacity for a person may be 10 lines, for another person can be, you know, 30 lines, for a person can be 5 minutes, for another person, or it can be 1 hour for a few people. There are a lot of fluent speakers. For them, there is no, they're sure they can speak in English as much as they want. They can speak in English for hours and hours, and without resorting back to their native language. So that is what we have to achieve, okay? And this particular technique helps you to become fluent in English. okay, and also increase your English speaking capacity. That is very, very important for you, right? So take up this particular technique, select 15 topic beforehand, before you are going to begin the technique, before those 15 set of days and 15, you know, topics, write them down somewhere, and then you can take up a sticky note and write 5 topics for next 5 days and stick it somewhere in your room where you can see, right? You can just do it, okay? And take up the 5 topics, speak them for next 5 days. Select your topics beforehand, guys, so that you are well prepared, you are well aware about that, okay, what you are supposed to speak. Now, from where to get these topics, because you have to be creative with the topics, right? So don't worry, you do not have to do any work, okay? I have so many videos for you where I am telling you topics to do your English speaking practice. Yes, go and check the videos that you can take the topics from there, okay? And I'm also giving you ideas what you can speak, what kind of, you know, content you can create to speak, okay, for a longer amount of time. Listen to that ideas, guys, that I am giving you, and then prepare your stuff, prepare your content, and do your English speaking practice alone at home. Okay, now here I'm going to talk about the number 2 technique, a morning mirror practice. Now, what is morning mirror practice? What we are supposed to do is we are supposed to kick start our day with positivity, with positive English speaking practice. Okay, so if you are taking up the technique of morning mirror practice, so here what you are doing is, right in the morning, you are creating kind of English awareness, okay, you know, English environment for yourself. Okay, that's, yes, you have done your English speaking practice, it will give you, you know, confidence, and it will act as a confidence boost for you, right? So that you can speak in English throughout the day. Okay, that means a positive English, that means a positive English start for the day. Okay, and it's going to be, you know, really helpful for you, as the name suggests, morning mirror practice. Okay, that means we are supposed to take up mirror talk here, and you know, but this is not just about standing in front of a mirror and saying anything, any random thing, and then just letting it go like that. No, it's not like that. Okay, it's not like that. You are supposed to do a mirror talk, but there is going to be a purpose behind it. Okay, number 1 is, whenever you are doing this mirror talk, you are supposed to take out 5 minutes of your busy schedule. Okay, you can do it. I know you can do it, right? After washing your face and all that, you feel fresh, you know, refreshed in the morning. At that particular time, you can do it, okay? Do not intermix it, okay, with any other morning kind of things. No, you are just focusing on your mirror practicing, okay? Either you can do before getting ready or after getting ready. And you are doing it. No, your mind is divided into 2 different tasks, getting ready because you have to reach your college or your office. So you have to do it, that one, or you might have 2 other tasks to do it. If not reaching college, even if you are working from home, okay, and anything like that, you have to get ready for that, whatever work you are doing, okay. You have to prepare for the night. Either give 5 minutes to yourself for your morning mirror practice, or before getting ready, or do it after getting ready, okay. So give it a proper time. Okay, in the morning, just 5 minutes, not more than 5 minutes, not more than 5 minutes. And I think that is something that you can, you know, manage right in the morning. So what you have to do is, you have to prepare for the day. Okay, either what you can do is, you can talk about some really positive things. Okay, any positive talk that you can do with yourself. Look at yourself in the mirror and just speak everything out loud. Okay, this is your morning English speaking practice. Okay, and that is morning mirror practice, I can say. So speaking everything out loud, you are doing that option as a number 2. Is what you can do is, you can plan your day, you can, you know, speak about whatever you are going to do today or in that particular day. Okay, so what is your plan for the day? You can just talk about in the mirror. You have to speak out loud and you have to look at yourself. You have to observe yourself, how you are speaking, everything. Okay, how you have to observe your body language also, your eye contact, how you have to make your eye contact with yourself while, you know, doing anything or while talking to somebody, right? So this is not only improving your speaking, but it's also improving everything associated to you, okay, associated with the speaking. That is your body language and your personality, your eye contact, everything. It will be maintained in just 5 minutes, of course, right? It's really powerful exercise, so you can do it for 5 minutes mirror, morning mirror practice. Now exercise number three. Well, exercise number three is to speak out loud with a podcast, speaking out loud with a podcast, right? Now this is very interesting and it's amazing. Why? Because you are not speaking out loud with a podcast, you are also taking some good English, right? This is an intake of good English, okay, because you are listening to it. Listening to good English is also, you know, important, and this particular sort of speaking practice is really great. If you do it in the evening time or at the night time, relax your mind, you know, it's you are done with the day, okay, you are done with a lot of tasks of yours, okay, and then your mind is relaxed and you can observe all the English, right? That you are listening to the phrases, the words, the pronunciations and everything. So you have to select a good quality podcast. That means a podcast where you are, you know, getting English, a reliable sources of English. And fluent accuracy is also important, guys. So you select a podcast as per your choice. It can be on anything, lifestyle, cooking, related to gaming, related to sports, related to entertainment, or anything, gardening, anything environmental, or it can be related to your thoughts, okay, whatever you choose or whatever you like. It can be educational too also. Whatever you want, select a podcast and listen to it, okay? So the step number one is that you just listen to it carefully and listen to it completely. A podcast is hardly of 10 or 12 or maybe, you know, 13 or 14 minutes, right? So you so we can give that much time to observe the things. And number one is we have to just listen to it completely and then begin once again, okay? Now in the second go, when you are listening to it once again, you have to speak out loud with us, with that podcast. And whatever is podcast saying, whatever the person is saying in that podcast, just speak it out loud. That means you have taken up the language, the phrases, the vocabulary, everything, okay? Now you are repeating it, okay? Now this is a very good format of remembering the phrases and the vocabulary and also developing the correct sentence structure. That is a concern a lot of people, that when they write English sentences, the structures are good, they are writing accurate English, but as soon as they speak, because of the nervousness, because of a lot of, you know, factors, they are not able to form those accurate sentences, structures and everything, right? But this is a particular method which I can just share with you right now, will help you to form a correct sentence structure, okay? Why? Because you are repeating those correct sentences structures speaking out loud. Podcast. That means you are repeating all the sentences and you are repeating all the sentence structures, the phrases, the words, and that are being said in that particular podcast, okay? So you are repeating, that means you are developing, okay? You are developing a memory of those words for yourself in your, you know, subconscious mind. So that are stored somewhere in your mind, in your memory. And it's easier for you to speak them out later on that, okay? And why it's important to do that? Speak out loud with a podcast. Now what you are doing is you are speaking ready-made sentences. Okay, have you heard that word ready-made? So these are the ready-made sentences. That means accuracy is also developing. You are speaking ready-made accurate sentences. That's a very good format, or that's a very good form of speaking practice, because you are using your mouth muscles. You are producing the sounds. Okay, you are producing the sounds that you need to become fluent in English. That means you practicing your English, you are speaking accurate English speaking, and you are using a lot of words and phrases, a variety of vocabularies, right, that you do not even use in a normal day-to-day life. Okay, so that you might not use, right? Now you are speaking it, now you are using it. That means you are developing a habit of using those vocabularies, those words, those phrases, those sentences in that way. Okay, and it's a great way to do your English speaking practice at home. So guys, these were the three exercises through which you can practice English speaking alone at home. Okay, so do you want to do this practice at home alone? If you are not having a partner, still you can do the practice in that format. Okay, well, you have these three, you know, exercises to develop this technique, exercises, techniques to practice English speaking without a partner alone at home. So now you can develop your fluency alone at home. You can develop your, you know, fluency by yourself practicing English. Pick up these three techniques and become fluent in English. So that's it for today's video, guys. And if you like the video, please give thumbs up. Let me know in the comment section that if you won't have some problem while speaking English. So let me know in the comment box, and I'll definitely share the things which you are facing right now and nowadays, right? If you like my video, please give thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And see you next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Take care.